Hey guys, it's Phaedra from All Things Phaedra, normally covering cars, travel, entertainment, and really cool stuff, which is what I'm doing today. Today, I am showing you Geno Palette. Doesn't look like much, it's a little box, but it's what I can do with this box. So before I open this, let me tell you, I have done the keto diet, the Whole30 diet, the Atkins diet, the South Beach diet. I'm probably, you know, giving my age a little bit here, but I've tried a lot of different things. I've done intermittent fasting, and they all work to varying degrees. Mainly, I need to just like eat less and move more. But all of that aside, I find that some diets actually work better for me, and I feel better on some of them. Now, why is that? Well, that's what Geno Palette is for. Geno Palette is here for you to take a DNA test. They'll analyze your DNA and they will tell you what is best for your genetic makeup. And they're gonna talk about proportions of proteins and fats and carbohydrates and what vitamins and minerals your body needs specifically. How do they do that? Well, we'll get into the science in just a minute, but before I do that, I have to actually open the kit, collect my DNA, and send it off to them. So let's take a look at what's inside. Open it up, and it's all about discovering a healthier you and a message from the founder of the company, Yi Sherry Zhang, PhD and co-founder. And they make it really super easy if you've ever done a DNA test. It looks something like this. So step one, swab your cheek and send us your DNA sample. Step two, your DNA arrives at our lab and we analyze it. Step three, you will receive your results within 3 to 5 weeks. Step four, use our app to gain insights into your nutritional needs. They send you a complete instruction booklet that tells you step by step, it's kind of dummy proof, how to do your DNA swab. It comes with a cotton swab for collecting your DNA, the swab vial, the biohazard bag, and then the prepaid envelope. Before you start collecting your DNA, you want to make sure that you've registered your kit so they know who you are. And when you send this in, they know who to associate this with. Now I'm ready to collect my DNA. Do not eat, drink, smoke, brush your teeth, or use mouthwash for 30 minutes before swabbing your cheek. I think I'm good. I feel like I got some pretty good DNA in there. Now it says to twist the swab into the vial. That's my DNA, everybody. Now we are going to seal it. Okay, make sure this is screwed on good. Don't want any DNA loss. We're gonna put it in the biohazard bag. I don't really like calling it biohazard, but. And then I'm gonna put this in the prepaid envelope and send it off for them to analyze me. And ready to be mailed. And as soon as I get this back, I'm gonna let you know what it says. Here we go. Well, that was fast. Actually, it took about 2 to 3 weeks for me to get my results back. It might take you a little bit longer. You'll get an email letting you know that your results are ready to view, and they recommend that you actually look at the results on your phone. They do have an app, the Geno Palette app, and on there, you're gonna log in and you'll see your personalized analysis. It'll tell you what your optimal foods are, it'll tell you your vitamins and minerals, and then it will tell you your recommended macro mix. I'm gonna show you mine, but I'm gonna show you the desktop version, which I don't think is as detailed, but I wanna give you a general idea of what kind of information you're gonna get from your results. I've just logged into Geno Palette on my desktop and it's personalized just for me. So everything that you're seeing here, the data is specifically for me based on my genetic information. And the first thing that you'll notice is my recommended macronutrient intake. And if you've done any other kind of diets like keto or high fat, low carb, you should be familiar with this pie chart. It's your proportions of carbohydrates, protein, and total fat. And this is what they're recommending for me. And I'm really kind of liking the look of this because who doesn't want more carbs in their diet? And you also see ranges for protein and for total fat. I'm not gonna get into food just yet because I wanna show you the detailed recommendations that they have here for macronutrients. So they break it down specifically by fat. So you can't just say, oh, I'm supposed to have 30% fat in my diet, I'm gonna go eat a bag of potato chips. Because if you look, they're going to tell you that of that, less than 8% of it should be saturated fat and omega-6 fats. Now, omega-6 aren't the good ones. The omega-3s are the good ones. So let's look at omega-3 fatty acids. And what they're telling me is we did not detect any impactful variants in your genes for this health domain. So they're not saying that I'm at risk for anything here, or I don't necessarily need more. So most of my recommendations are just going to be pretty general here. Let's find something that's a little bit more specific to me. So here we go. Monounsaturated fatty acid. And it's okay if you don't know what they are, but it's saying, Phaedra, based on your genetics, you may benefit from increasing your monounsaturated fat acid intake to 12 to 17% of total daily calories. And if I were to do that, people that have a genetic makeup similar to mine have noticed that they have a decreased BMI, body mass index. And let me tell you, my BMI could use a little decreasing. So let's say you don't know what that is. You don't know what these monounsaturated fatty acids are, but these are the types that can help you reduce LDLs. I'm gonna get a little personal here and tell you that my cholesterol tends to be, it's creeping up there on the higher side, but I specifically have high LDL. So this is important to me. It says my best sources for monounsaturated fatty acids are things like meats, fats and oils, nuts and seeds, and they specifically say olive oil. I actually use a ton of olive oil. I eat a lot of walnuts. I eat a lot of hard-boiled eggs, so I feel like I'm doing pretty good. Let's see what happens when we click into this. And it's going to take me to my fats and oils section. So it's actually telling me that the best oils for me are safflower oil and hazelnut oil. Almond oil and olive oil are great, and good would be sunflower seed oil. So that would mean that other oils maybe don't have, it doesn't mean they're bad for me, but they maybe don't have the same health benefits. Let's look at proteins. So it's saying I should get 19 to 25% protein. And based on my genes, I may benefit from increasing my protein to make sure it's at that point. This helps build and repair tissues. It helps support enzyme and hormone functions, and my best sources for protein. I don't love meat, so I'm kind of curious as to what they'll tell me. Nuts and seeds, meats, seafoods, and other proteins. So try adding a nut butter or similar alternative. And I'm gonna see nuts and seeds, what they recommend. They are recommending almonds, which are okay, chia seeds, okay, flax seeds, and soy nuts. Interesting. Great would be hazelnuts, macadamia nuts, and peanuts. And then good would be pumpkin seeds, pistachios, and sesame seeds. And I'm wondering, where are my cashews? They're not on here. I do actually like almond butter, so that works really well for me. Now, if you notice, they give you recommendations for all your different foods. So the best vegetables are the fried ones, am I right? I'm just kidding, a little. So artichokes, okay, I'm growing some, that's great. Winter squash, red bell pepper, jalapeno peppers, pumpkin, banana peppers. This is not what I expected. And then down here, these tend to be higher carb vegetables, Brussels sprouts, broccoli, and okra. There's nothing on here that I really dislike except for maybe red bell peppers. Oh, leafy vegetables is a whole separate category. Collard greens, turnip greens, mustard greens. None of those are my favorite. We looked at nuts and seeds, the legumes, beans I've never heard of, adzuki beans, navy beans, black beans, and other kinds. I do like lentils. Let's look at herbs. So the best for me, garlic. Garlic has a lot of anti-inflammatory properties. And a bay leaf or bay leaves. I use those in cooking. Spearmint, parsley, and scallions. Okay. Starches and grains. Sweet potatoes, I know. Quinoa, yes. Peas, yes. Amaranth is not something I've tried. I'm gonna just dive into amaranth a little bit and see what we find. So now it's telling me why amaranth is good for me. I'm gonna click through some of these. These are some of the best fruits and cheeses. Ooh, I love ricotta and cottage cheese. Meats, I did ask them to exclude pork because I don't generally eat pork, but they are recommending a lot of beef, which is really interesting because on the rare occasion that I crave meat, it's almost always beef. There's one more thing that I didn't mention, and that is sensitivities. So on the app, they do look at your genetics to see if they have found anything that might relate your genetic makeup to sensitivities to caffeine, gluten, alcohol, and lactose. The only thing they found was that I have one particular set of genetic variants that they can tie to caffeine. And what they have said is based on the genetic variants that I have no sensitivity to caffeine. So that's a good thing. The other things, lactose, gluten, alcohol, they didn't have any genetic information to make recommendations there. The one last thing that Geno Palette does is they offer you personalized supplements. Now, this is a way that they can make money from your genetic information, and that's not a bad thing. What they do is they have a personalized blend of supplements that provide you, in the proportions that you need, those nutrients that they recommend for your genetic makeup. What you do with that information is entirely up to you. So, what have I discovered in this whole process? Well, I found that I'm willing to give my DNA freely. And if you have already done a DNA test, like through 23andMe or Ancestry, you don't have to resubmit your DNA. You can actually, for a lower cost, have them use those genetic samples to give you your Geno Palette profile. I did my whole DNA profile through Geno Palette, and I got my results, and I think this is really cool stuff because it is science. These days, people like to throw around the "I believe in science" terminology. You have to remember that science is provisional. We know what we know until we know something different or until we know something more. So I love that we're finding new ways to explore the human body by mapping these genetic components and seeing what that can mean for our health and for our nutrition. So I'm excited to take part in this, and if you're interested in trying it out or maybe purchasing it as a gift for somebody, I'd like to recommend that you click on the link below, and that will take you directly to the Geno Palette website and give you a chance to purchase either one of the kits, either with or without a new DNA sample. If you have any other questions about Geno Palette and about whether or not this has impacted my diet over time, leave me a comment. I'll be sure to get back to you and let you know, because maybe I do need more butternut squash in my life. In conclusion, I would love it if you hit that subscribe button, because I talk about a lot of really cool stuff and I try a lot of really cool things, so you don't necessarily have to. I submitted my DNA just for you, so I hope you give this video a thumbs up, leave me a comment, and be sure to let me know anytime you find really cool stuff.